Best thing about touring is touring. To me, is traveling. Just being around the world and meeting all different people and their, you know, different types of cultures. Fans that have seen our shows before, you know, that are expecting something big, this is something big. And for people that have never seen our show before, we want both people to leave our show with this everlasting impression of the Backstreet Boys.
Wir haben euch vermisst, yeah.
The boys have lots of ways of making an everlasting impression on you. They can serenade you in Spanish.
Mi espíritu en busca de tu amor.
Donde quieras yo iré, al fin del mundo llegaré.
Impress you in Italian.
Non puoi lasciarmi così.
Non mi lasciare.
Lo sai.
Into a hairbrush.
I never wanna hear you say I want it that way. How your love's affecting our reality.
And even though it's said that white men can't jump, the boys prove that they sure have rhythm.
And that makes you larger than life.
My love is so.
Lusted after by girls the world over, but it's not all great, as this can make it very difficult for them to have a regular relationship.
If I'm in a relationship and I'm with a girl and I've been with her long enough that it's important enough that I want to profess it to the world, then I'll do that.
If she's walking out in public and people know her and they relate her to, you know, oh, that's AJ's girlfriend, that's Nick's girlfriend, that's Harry's girlfriend, you know, it could be a good thing or it could be a bad thing. I mean, but some people nowadays, I think if it's other artists that are together, sometimes that's looked upon differently as an artist with someone who's not another artist.
I know you guys. Let's have a toast.
Okay.
Yeah, just skiing.
Yes.
Yes. Come off out.
Yes. Yes.
To guys.
Oh, come on, you guys, you know she just broke up with her boyfriend.
Oh, she's not the only one. The boys are responsible for breaking hearts worldwide. And when the Backstreet Boys are singing, emotions can run high. Even Brian's moved to tears by their music. Or is that something in his eye?
Oh, girl, if you give me one more chance.
When I first worked with the Backstreet Boys, and it was like, okay, follow me. And I was going, what did I get myself into? I was just like, the beat is here, fella.
Stop. Hold it. Read. Check it out.
We've grown with her since the first video. We've all gotten tighter and better as dancers. But more or less, we are a vocal group, but she's really helped us a lot. A lot.
Oh my God, we're back again. Brothers, sisters, everybody say.
It was hard to convince the record label to do this video because it was a risk. Doing this type of treatment, if it wasn't done with the right budget, the right costumes, the right choreography, corny.
What we wanted to do was take, like, kind of like the Michael Jackson Thriller thing. And just make it a little bit different, more of a 90s feel. You know, of course, a little bit lower budget than that was.
with
five guys, you know, and just, you know, take, of course, the monster characters and, you know, have dancing in it. And it was just, it was really fun.
We feel like our forte is our singing more so than our dancing. But
We have a great choreographer who's been working with us for a while, Fatima Robinson. She works with everybody. She started out, I think her big break was when she did Michael Jackson's Remember the Times video.
Yeah.
And she helps us do our thing, and she's helped us grow as performers and as dancers as well.
Oh, isn't Kevin modest? Well, all those dancing lessons sure have paid off. Just look at them now.
Dancing, nothing left for me to do but dance. All these bad times I've gone through, just dance, hey. Got Kevin in my heels tonight, baby.
So much to ask.
Every time we go to the airport looking to see if there's any fans to see it now, it's like, you know, we're getting escorted out of airports, we're getting kicked out of hotels because of too many fans, you know, not enough security control. So it's, you know, it's a really overwhelming feeling, you know, to see how where it started to where it's at now. We were trying to make a quick exit out of the hotel to the bus, and there was fans lined, just mega fans on both sides of the entrance to the bus, a little pathway there. We had to make a mad dash for it, and they said, run, run, run. Kevin ran, then I ran right after him, and we just got out of control. The security couldn't handle it, and the fans were actually grabbing us and, like, you know, shaking us around. And then Nikki comes right behind me and didn't see that they were holding me. He runs right into me, and I fall on the ground. My first sore from a fan. Besides getting the hair pulled, but that's all right. I got too much. They can't grab too much, but I don't have too much hair.
They grab Nick's real good.
Like an hour and a half away from Orlando, and they would shuttle tourists to my house in buses.
They were selling tours.
And they were selling tours, and eventually had to put up a security fence. And it's gotten that bad. I mean, they were actually coming to my lawn, like taking like plants and stuff out of it. So.
Larger than life. It's a song about the fans and how they make us feel.
We were like throwing up all kinds of names, trying to find something that really caught our eye, and we really liked the title Larger Than Life because the song is dedicated to all of our fans. But we thought, you know, Backstreet Boys, Larger Than Life, that would just be totally taken the wrong way. Like- we figured what better way for us to come into the new millennium with Backstreet Boys, Millennium, it just fit, it was just right.
Artists have started out not writing all their songs like Janet and Michael and Madonna. They grew into it, and that's something that we want to do.
One thing the boys aren't ready to do just yet are the much-rumored solo projects, and they're going to be around for quite a while yet.
Every week, it seems like we have to do damage control or something because there's a big rumor spreading that we're breaking up.
I am not leaving the group. I have no intentions of leaving the group.
Nick, are you leaving the group?
No, I'm not, man.
It gets frustrating after the 15th or 20th time that you have to go on in front of a camera and send a video over to Europe.
Leaving the group, Brian?
No, I'm not leaving the group either. I have no intentions of leaving the group.
Everything's cool, you know, we're not breaking up. So just wanted to let everybody know that it's all good.
It's cool.
Got a lot to do as a group, maybe down the road, but right now it's the Millennium album and the world tour that we're focusing on.
I also let you know when or whenever it does happen in the future, we are going to be behind each other, you know, and no matter what happens, like, we're always going to be a group.
All you people, can't you see, can't you see?